y'all don't mind, let's go back to a time when we really used to have church. We used to have a good time, praising the Lord, in spirit and in truth.
I love them old church.
That old brother, pick up that old hymn book and
singing,
you knew exactly what he was gonna say. Sisters got happy, folks start patting their feet, clapping their hands, and horn was set. He break off in a song, something like this.
We had Brother Hines, book of 1 Kings chapter 18, and there are 20 lessons in the book was read, but I want to take my lessons from verse number 21. I think it's apropos with all the things that are going on. I want you to know that you can trust your ministry, you can trust the work at Uptown Church of Christ and your children to learn the truth that is in Christ Jesus. But we have really good lesson about why it's important to praise God and what it is. And I just pray that we all give God our undivided attention through His Word that we can grow by. We'll talk to you from the subject matter, living between two opinions. Living between two opinions. And I want you, for a secondary subject matter, ain't no half step. Right. Amen. Ain't no half step. Amen. We serve a God that's an all in God. 1 Kings 18, verses 21. Verse 21. We had all that reading too. But verse 21 is where I'm launching. And just say it, man, when you have it. Hold on, preacher. I'm still looking.
Yeah.
Amen. Y'all tell me to hold on, I'll start preaching. Amen. Amen. So let me set up the backdrop of 1 Kings 18, verse 21. We know the story of Elijah. We know that he was standing against the false prophets, Baal. We know that he felt alone, he felt distance. We know that he felt that he was the only one that would stand for what's right. That the children of Israel had begun to associate themselves with false gods and idol gods, and begin to mix and mingle the worship of the one true God with the worship of idols, of Baal. And it seems like a familiar argument even today, that any church is the Lord's church. That of course there could be many gods, there could be many churches, and this was a caring at the expense of prophets. Prophets had been murdered for preaching the truth, just as they would man preach to you that there is but one church. They wrestled with the idea that there could only be one God, and folk were wrestling with the idea that there could only be one church. And people are wrestling with our baseline scriptures of what established the church, and we know that God purchased the church with his blood. Am I right about it? And we understand, and we heard from years and years back, and I still preach this. There is but one Lord, one faith, and one baptism. One God was above you all, and through you all, and in you all. I believe that the Bible is right. I believe that when we drift back into Elijah's day and time, where people are sitting here right now, wrestling in their mind that there is another church other than the Lord's church, that Elijah's point is well taken. Elijah asked the question that I asked you this morning as a listening audience. How long, the Bible says, he came before them all, as I stand before you, and I said, how long will you stand halt between two opinions?
Well,
if God is God, then serve him. If there's just one God, then serve that one God. Right. But if Baal is God, then follow him. And the Bible says that they answered not a word.
Yeah.
My question to you is, if the church of Christ is the Lord's church to you, then serve the Lord in the church of Christ.
Yeah.
And if denominationalism appeals to you and you believe that polytheism and atheism is okay too, then go do that. But for God's sake, make up your mind, man. Because there is no half-stepping with the Lord and the right about it. God said that you have read my word. You know what I've said, and my word will stand forever. And so since you have heard the church teaching and the church doctrine that there not only is there one God, but there's one doctrine. Am I right about it? And every time the Bible refers to doctrines, he says in a negative way. Remember in 1 Timothy 1 about verse number 4, now the Spirit speaketh expressly that in the letter he that transgresseth abide not in the doctrine of Christ, have not God. But he that abideth in the doctrine of the Lord have both the Father and the Son. And if any come unto you like they came unto Elijah and don't bring this doctrine, he said, don't you even bid him? God speak. The man of God is charged to preach the truth. But if folk like the truth or not, even if it cost the prophet his life, he has to stand and preach the truth.
Amen.
This historical setting is relevant today to you because he used the word, how long shall you stand halt between two spirits? The word halt in Hebrew meant, how long shall you bounce back and forth between two thought processes? Well, some of us are bouncing back and forth between whether or not there is instrumental music or not instrumental music. Some of us are bouncing back and forth whether or not we are Baptists, whether we're Jehovah's Witness, or whether or not we're Church of Christ. Some of us are bouncing even within the Church of Christ according to our likeness. Yes. It is modern day polytheism, which means that I believe there are many gods and many churches, and the church is spiritual and I can do whatever I want. He said, how long will you be halt or will you bounce back and forth between two opinions? Another rendering of the definition of the word halt also means not only to bounce back, he was saying, how long will you be spiritually lame? Don't you know it's spiritually lame to act like God can't deliver his church? Y'all know what I'm saying? Amen. I don't care what excuse you got. He says, how long will you be hung between two opinions? He said, that's a lame behavior. Mm-hmm. The young people now, they don't like somebody say, he's so lame. Mm-hmm. He's like, we used to say he was an L7. Well, they still got the L, but now they say he's lame. Am I right about it? Y'all don't know about the L7. You're too young. But if you was older than that, well, you saw a chick that she's an L7, Doc. Because we had flunked. And we still remember the square, the T square, and the seven, man. So y'all are saying, amen. All right. And so when we look at this great passage of scripture, we'll find he said, how long will you be lame as the people of God? How long will you wrestle with the ideal that there could be more than one God? There is only one God.
Amen.
God is a fact, he is not an opinion.
Amen.
God is an absolute fact, he is not an opinion. And God, and Elijah stands in the gap. He stands in the middle and he says, as I said to you, it is time for you to make a decision. There is no half-stepping with God. Well, what type of person did it produce in the text? It produced a person who has decided to sin and serve. Y'all make that point number one. He produced a person who was sinning and serving. On the one hand, they were serving God. On the other hand, they could just as well go to Baal and have church. In other words, no matter where I go, it's still God, it's still worship. Y'all heard that before, haven't you? Heard that before. But I want you to understand that you can't sin and serve. Even in the church, you can't sin and serve. And don't let nobody tell you that grace will allow you to sin and serve. There's a difference in sinning and living in sin. I'm talking about folks who are, we all have what?
Sin.
Sin and then what?
Fall short
of what? The glory of God. So it's not the fact that we sin, it's the fact that we live in sin. And as we battle this attitude, this mindset, that somehow we're going to be able to sin and serve, Elijah says, well, now listen, you have sinned because you need to make a decision. My challenge to every one of you that are half-stepping, that are sinning and serving, that's going home right back doing what you did last week, that's in stuff that you have no intention of coming out of, that you half-stepping. There is no half-stepping with God in the right of God. Listen to Joshua chapter 24 and verse number 14. I don't want 15, I want 24 and verse number 15. Now therefore, fear the Lord and serve him with sincerity and in truth. The word fear is not to be afraid of God, but to respect God. He said, if you're going to worship God, have a relationship with God, you need to have some respect for God. What should I respect? I should respect that the God of heaven came down from glory one day, took on the form of man, received your nails, and received your thorns, and received your crown, and bled on Calvary's cross for your sins and my sins. And as he was bleeding, he was paying for the church. Am I right? And to the Father, which the Holy Ghost has made you overseer, which he has purchased with his own blood. 5 Peter 1:19, the Bible says, and Bible study Christian. Amen. I want a Christian that worship me in the morning time. Amen. I want a Christian that worship me in the evening time. Amen. I want a Christian that'll worship me in the noon hour. Am I right about it?
Yeah.
I want a Christian that'll worship me when times seem bleak and sirens seem dreary. I want a Christian, I want a person who's going to worship me whether times are good or bad. I don't want you half stepping with me. Yeah. I want either all of you or none of you.
Yeah.
Because we have produced a weak and impotent church of Christ.
Mm-hmm.
Well, seldom, even in the church, we hear sermons about the church of Christ. Preachers are cowards that will not preach against sin. Fearful that they might lose their $5 or something.
Mm-hmm.
They just soon have 70 people on their way to hell than 10 people that's about going to heaven.
Yeah.
Cause they are psychotic, slightly mentally retarded.
Mm-hmm.
They say it's better to preach a popular lesson than to preach the truth that's in Christ Jesus.
Uh-huh.
I'm like Elijah. All the prophets have left. And I'm the only one standing here.
Mm-hmm.
And since I'm here, I might as well preach.
Amen.
The truth about Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
Yes, you cut the heads off of everybody else. Yes, you killed all 12 of the apostles. But you might as well add me to the list, because as long as there's breath in my body, I'm going to preach the same gospel that we preach in the old time.
Yeah.
You can't be gambling. I look at him and tell you, I go to the head house, but I ain't sitting with the preacher either. They tell me. But I'm not walking around talking, but I'm going to preach. God, For his God an equally yoke with unbelievers?
Mm-hmm.
For what fellowship have righteousness with unrighteousness? And what communion have light with darkness? What concord have Christ with Baal?
Oh, yeah.
What part have the infidel with Christ? And what agreement have the temple of God with the temple of idols? For I have said that I should be your God, and you should be my people, and I should dwell in you and walk in them. Am I right about it? Are you pricked in your heart? Do you understand that just coming is not enough? There is